प्रेज द लॉर्ड. आजच्या रविवारच्या फादर्स डेच्या स्पेशल उपासनेत मी सर्व उपस्थितांचे प्रभू येशूच्या नावात स्वागत करतो. सर्वात प्रथम मंडळीतल्या सर्व फादर्सला फादर्स डेच्या हार्दिक शुभेच्छा. परमेश्वर आपल्या लोकांभोवती आहे. ज्यांचा भाव परमेश्वरावर आहे ते निश्चल व सर्वात काळ टिकणाऱ्या सियोन डोंगरासारखे आहेत. यरुशलेमेच्या सभोवती डोंगर आहेत तसा परमेश्वर आपतापासून सर्व काळ आपल्या लोकांभोवती आहे. नीतिमनाचे हात दुष्कर्माला लागू नयेत म्हणून दुर्जनाची दंडेली नीतिमनाच्या वतनावर चालणार नाही. हे परमेश्वरा, जे चांगले व सरळ मनाचे आहेत त्यांचे कल्याण कर. जे आपल्या कुटुंब मार्गांकडे वळतात त्यांना परमेश्वर दुष्कर्म्यांबरोबर घालवून दे. इस्रायला शांती असो. स्तुती स्तुती स्तुतीस पात्र असं माझ्या महान तोर जयंत बाप्पा. तुझ्या नावाला महान महिमा आणि गौरव असो. गेल्या आठवड्याभर तुम्ही सांभाळ केलास प्रभू, आणि आजच्या सुंदरशा रविवारच्या दिवशी तुझ्या ऑनलाईन उपासना सर्वांनी एकत्रित केली असं तुला धन्यवाद देतो. दे बाप्पा, या पॅन्डेमिक सिच्युएशनमध्ये तुमचा विषय सांभाळ करतो असं तुला धन्यवाद देतो प्रभू. आजच्या उपासनेत आम्ही फादर्स डे साजरा करीत आहोत प्रभू. सर्वात प्रथम मी तुला गौरव देतो कारण की तू आमचा स्वर्गीय पिता आहेस. दे बाप्पा, आजच्या भक्तीमध्ये गीतांद्वारे व वचनांद्वारे तुझा गौरव होते. आमच्या प्रत्येकांच्या अंतकरणाचा ताबा तू घे प्रभू. सर्व जगी विचारापासून तू आम्हाला दूर ठेव आणि तुझ्या स्तुतीमध्ये आम्हाला सर्वांना एकचित्त होऊ दे प्रभू. पुढची भक्तीचा प्रवाह तू घे हे नाहीसे प्रार्थना करतो मी प्रभू. येशूच्या बोल पवित्र नावाने मागतो म्हणतो आहे. यावेळेस आपण देवबाप्पाच्या गौरवासाठी उपासना संगीतामधून गीत क्रमांक 33 गाऊ.
दिव्य लू
सर्व समर्थ देव जो पिता आकाश व पृथ्वी यांचा उत्पन्न करणारा आणि येशू ख्रिस्त त्याचा एकुलता एक पुत्र आमचा प्रभू जो पवित्र आत्म्याच्या योगाने गर्भरूप झाला कुमारी मरिया इसपासून जन्मला ज्याने पंतपिलाताच्या वेळेस दुःख भोगले ज्याला वधस्तंभी दिले जो मरण पावला व ज्याला पुरिले तिसऱ्या दिवशी मेलेल्यामधून पुन्हा उठला स्वर्गात चढला आणि सर्व शक्तिमान देव जो पिता त्याच्या उजवीकडे बसला आहे तेथून जिवंतांचा व मेलेल्यांचा न्याय कराव्यास जो येणार आहे त्याविषयी मी विश्वास धरितो पवित्र आत्मा पवित्र सार्वत्रिक मंडळी पवित्रांची सहभागिता पापांची क्षमा देहाचे पुनरुत्थान आणि सनातन जीवन याविषयी मी विश्वास धरितो आमेन यावेळेस मध्यस्थीची प्रार्थना होईल मी आशुतोषेला प्रार्थना करण्यासाठी विनंती करीत आहे
आपण प्रार्थना करूया धन्यवाद 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 अब्राहम इसाक आणि याकोबाचा जिवंत देव तो आमचा देव तुझ्या नावाला कोटी कोटी धन्यवाद देतो देवप्पा हा सुंदरसा दिवस आम्हाला हा दाखवला देवप्पा आणि सुंदरशी ऑपॉर्च्युनिटी तू आम्हाला दिली म्हणून खूप खूप धन्यवाद देतो देवप्पा रात्रभर तू आम्हाला सांभाळलं देवप्पा आणि हा नवीन जीवन तू ऍड केलं म्हणून कोटी कोटी धन्यवाद देतो देवप्पा देवप्पा आम्ही मनुष्य देवप्पा आम्ही सतत पाप करतो देवप्पा आमचे पाप लाखेसारखे लाल झाले देवप्पा ते तू पांढऱ्या बर्फासारखे शुभ्र केले म्हणून धन्यवाद देतो देवप्पा देवप्पा तू आमचा पिता आहे देवप्पा तू आमचा स्वर्गीय पिता आहे देवप्पा तुला हर एक गोष्ट आमच्या जीवनातली माहीत आहे देवप्पा तुला आमच्या जीवनामध्ये हर एक अडीअडचणी माहीत आहे देवप्पा हर एक गोष्टी तू आम्हाला पुरवतं म्हणून धन्यवाद देतो देवप्पा देवप्पा तुझ्या समोर आमच्या अंतकरणातील हर एक इच्छा आकांक्षा उघडी आहे देवप्पा तुला हर एक गोष्ट माहीत आहे देवप्पा आणि त्या तू लवकरच पुरवणार आहे हा आमचा पूर्ण विश्वास आहे देवप्पा देवप्पा तू आम्हाला तुझ्या मार्गावर चालव देवप्पा तुझी योजना आमच्यासाठी काय आहे देवप्पा आमच्या लाईफमध्ये काय आहे देवप्पा आम्हाला कळू नये होते देवप्पा तू आमचे आत्मिक डोळे उघड देवप्पा जेणेकरून आम्हाला कळू दे देवप्पा तुझे प्लॅन्स आमच्यासाठी काय आहे देवप्पा देवप्पा आम्हाला तुझ्यासारखं मांसळ हृदय दे देवप्पा देवप्पा तू आमचा पिता आहे देवप्पा आम्ही तुझ्याकडे तुझ्याशिवाय आम्ही कोणाकडे मागू देवप्पा तुला आमच्या हर एक गरजा माहीत आहे देवप्पा देवप्पा आजचा हा दिवस मी तुझ्या हाती सोपतो देवप्पा हा फादर्स डे मी तुझ्या हाती सोपतो देवप्पा हर एक फादर्सला तू ब्लेस कर आशीर्वादित कर देवप्पा देवप्पा प्रार्थना करतो देवप्पा सिंगल पॅरेंट्ससाठी देवप्पा जे काही पॅरेंट्स देवप्पा जे काही मॉम देवप्पा पॅरेंट्स फादर्सचा रोल प्ले करत आहे देवप्पा त्यांना आशीर्वादित कर देवप्पा हीच माझी प्रार्थना देवप्पा हर एक गोष्टीसाठी कोटी कोटी धन्यवाद होतो देवप्पा मागण्या पलीकडे देणारा पिता तू आहे देवप्पा येशूच्या नावात प्रार्थना मागतो म्हणून तू एक
यावेळी शास्त्रभागाचे वाचन होईल मी प्रतीकेला आपल्यासाठी शास्त्रभागाचे वाचन करण्यासाठी विनंती करीत आहे
लुक्याचा 11वा अध्याय वचन 1 ते 13 प्रभूची प्रार्थना मग असे झाले की तो एका ठिकाणी प्रार्थना करीत होता ती त्याने समाप्त केल्यावर त्याच्या शिष्यातील एकाने त्याला म्हटले प्रभूजी जसे योहानाने आपल्या शिष्यांना प्रार्थना करावयास शिकवले तसे आपणही आम्हाला शिकवा तो त्यांना म्हणाला, तुम्ही प्रार्थना कराल तेव्हा असे म्हणा, हे पित्या, तुझे नाव पवित्र मानिले जावो, तुझे राज्य येवो, आमची रोजची भाकर रोज आम्हाला दे, आणि आम्हाला आमच्या पापांची क्षमा कर, कारण आम्हीही आपल्या प्रत्येक ऋणयाला क्षमा करीतो, आणि आम्हाला परीक्षेत आणू नको. आग्रहाची प्रार्थना व मध्यरात्री आलेल्या मित्राचा दृष्टांत. मग त्याने त्यांना म्हटले, तुमच्यामध्ये असा कोण आहे की त्याला मित्र असो तो त्याच्याकडे मध्यरात्री जाऊन त्याला म्हणतो, मित्रा मला 3 भाकरी अन्न दे, कारण माझा एक मित्र प्रवासाहून माझ्याकडे आला आहे आणि त्याला वाढवयास माझ्याजवळ काही नाही. आणि तो आतून उत्तर देईल, मला त्रास देऊ नको, आता दार लावले आहे व माझी मुले माझ्याजवळ निजली आहेत, मी उठवून तुला देऊ शकत नाही. मी तुम्हाला सांगतो, तो त्याचा मित्र आहे, यामुळे जरी तो उठवून त्याला देणार नाही तरी त्याच्या आग्रहामुळे त्याला पाहिजे तितक्या भाकरी तो उठवून त्याला देईल. मी तुम्हास सांगतो, मागा म्हणजे तुम्हास दिले जाईल, शोधा म्हणजे तुम्हास सापडेल, ठोका म्हणजे तुम्हासाठी उघडले जाईल, कारण जो कोणी मागतो त्याला मिळते, जो कोणी शोधतो त्याला सापडते, जो कोणी ठोकतो त्याच्यासाठी उघडले जाईल. तुमच्यामध्ये असा कोण बाप आहे की जो आपल्या मुलाने मासा मागितला असता त्याला मासा न देता साप देईल, किंवा अंडे मागितले असता त्याला विंचू देईल? तुम्ही वाईट असताही तुम्हाला आपल्या मुलांना चांगल्या देणग्या द्यावयाचे कळते, तर मग स्वर्गीय पित्याजवळ जे मागतात त्यास तो किती विशेष करून पवित्र आत्मा देईल. प्रभू असल्या वचनावरती आशीर्वाद.
आता आपण देवबाबाच्या गौरवासाठी प्रेझेंट वर्शिप मध्ये जाऊ. मी शालोमेला प्रेझेंट वर्शिप साठी विनंती करीत आहे. Thank you.
singing forever. Holy is the Lord. Holy is the Lord. Holy is the Lord.
यावेळेस मी संदेश येण्यासाठी मी सिओना सामंत हिला आमंत्रित करीत आहे.
I wish all the fathers and all the single mothers a very happy Father's Day. We are very lucky and we are very happy to have you in our lives and we really love you. Before starting with the sermon, apan chotishi prarthna kariya. Thank you Lord, thank you Jesus, thank you Holy Spirit, O Lord. Thank you for giving us this beautiful day, O Lord Jesus. Thank you for showing us this beautiful morning, O Lord Jesus. Thank you for getting us in your presence, O Lord. As we are celebrating Father's Day, Jehova, आज आम्ही मी तुला सर्व सर्व फादर्सला सर्व सिंगल मदर्सला तुझ्या हातात देते, लॉर्ड. आय वॉन्ट यू टू टेक कंट्रोल ऑफ देम, लॉर्ड. दे हॅव ऑलवेज सॅक्रिफाईस देअर हॅपीनेस, लॉर्ड. दे आर विशेस फॉर अस, लॉर्ड. अँड आय वॉन्ट यू टू फिल देम विथ युअर हॅपीनेस. आय वॉन्ट यू टू ब्लेस देम. आय वॉन्ट यू टू कवर देम विथ युअर ब्लड, लॉर्ड जीसस. ॲज दे आर टेकिंग केअर ऑफ अस, लॉर्ड, लॉर्ड, फिल देम विथ युअर स्पिरिट, लॉर्ड जीसस. लॉर्ड, वॉट एव्हर आय एम गोइंग टू टॉक, लॉर्ड, टुडे ऑन फादर्स डे, लॉर्ड जीसस, देवपा ही जी पण मी सर्मन रेडी केलं आहे, देवपा हे देवपा तुला खुश करो, देवपा. अँड लेट द सर्मन बी यूज इन युअर किंगडम, लॉर्ड जीसस. अँड लॉर्ड, वॉट एव्हर आय एम गोइंग टू टॉक, लॉर्ड, देवपा ते लोकांपर्यंत पोहोचावं. अँड लेट पीपल अंडरस्टँड, लॉर्ड. थँक्यू फॉर दिस डे, लॉर्ड. थँक्यू फॉर दिस मुवमेंट, लॉर्ड. थँक्यू फॉर लिसनिंग टू आवर प्रेयर, लॉर्ड. इन जीसस नेम आय प्रे, आमेन. आय विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट सम अमेझिंग फादर्स in the Bible who taught us and who teach us still that how important fathers are in our life. If we see and if we actually pay attention to it, upon Mother's Day la khup jaast importance deto, more than Father's Day. I'm not saying that upon Mother's Day la importance nahi dala paije, but I feel fathers also should get the equal importance. Mothers ashe ahet, our mothers are something which will, you know, are someone who will express themselves and tell how they feel about the situation. But aapne fathers will never express, they will never actually tell how they are feeling about. But without expressing, they have sacrificed so many things for us. We can't even imagine so many things. The time when we were born, the time when we actually got in school, in college, graduated, we got married or got kids. He has done each and everything for us. And it's so big and it's so huge that we can't even, you know, count how many times he has done things for us. The Bible reading which we have done today is Luke 11. I think a week ago I was reading it and I just thought that how important that verse is, how important that chapter is, and how Jesus tells us how important Father is. So tya vachnavar mi nantar jain. Before that I'll be talking about some people in our Bible. I'll be starting with Noah, and I have named Noah as the successful father. I have named him as a successful father. Why and what are the reasons? Here I am sagya goshti explain karin. As we all know that Noah was famous for building his ark, and how strong and how faithful he was in God and how he kept believing in God. But at the same time, people called him crazy. Like obviously, out of sudden, if koni sangitla tumhala ki, you know, you are going to die and you have to go from here and me ek aag bandhar and I want everyone inside it, you won't understand. You will be like, kaya bolat hai. And that was the same situation there too. People thought that what is he doing? And they said, okay, kaya chalu hai. But even if people called him crazy, he never let that questions, let that remarks bothered him. What he did was, he still believed in God. He still had faith in God. And with that faith, he went ahead. He built that up. That's a kadipan to faith, kadipan ikda tikda nahi gela. It never went from, you know, like high to low. Asa kadi zhala nahi. We see Noah as a successful father. Why? Because he was so obedient to God. And seeing him, it inspired his kids and he inspired his family. Because obviously we are our children, we look up to our fathers. We see how they do, how good things they are in and what they do and how they do their job. And then so vishwas kiti hai devavar. We see that. And tashas tencha pan mulani, Noahcha mulani. Nohala bagitla, and they believed how great father is. You know, there are times when if we, you know, compare when people were calling him crazy with our situation, it's like when aple fathers aplele goshta sangtat, like, you know, maybe don't talk to someone, that person, or don't do this, or don't go here. It's like we still do it. We feel that person is overreacting. Like example, maja life mali, I had a friend like 2-3 years ago. And maja papa ni mala sangit lela that she's a good friend, but she is not good for you. She might hurt you in future. But me te nahi ikla. I was very ignorant about it. I was like, nah, papa overreact karta de. But that's not the whole thing. After some years, I realized that, you know, that person was not good for me. And kya mala khala that papa was telling me something which never happened that time, but he could see something is wrong. Vajay Devani and him having a faith in God, he understood that something would go wrong with me if I still keep talking. The tasach lokani pa nohala crazy samajla, but he never left his faith and he was still believing. If we read Genesis 6, that's 6, 9 to 12, we realize Genesis 6 verses 9 to 21. This is the account of Noah and his family. Noah was a righteous man, blameless among the people of his time. And he walked faithfully with God. Noah had three sons, Shem, Ham, and Japheth. Now the earth was corrupt in God's sight and was full of violence. God saw how corrupt the earth had become, for all the people on earth had corrupted their ways. So God said to Noah, I am going to put an end to all the people, for the earth is filled with violence because of them. I am surely going to destroy both them and the earth. So make yourself an ark of cypress wood, make rooms in it, and coat it with pitch inside and out. This is how you are to build it. The ark is to be 300 cubits long, 50 cubits wide, and 30 cubits high. Make a roof for it, leaving below the roof and opening one cubit high all around. Put a door in the side of the ark and make lower, middle, and upper decks. I am going to bring flood on the earth to destroy all life under the heavens, every creature and that has the breath of life in it. Everything on earth will perish, but I will establish my covenant with you and you will enter the ark. You and your sons and your wife and your son's wife with you. You are going to bring the ark into the ark two of living creatures, male and female, to keep them aligned with you. Two of every kind of bird, of every kind of animal, and of every kind of creature that moves along the ground will come to you to be kept alive. You are to take every kind of food that is to be eaten and store it away as food for you, for them. Noah did everything just as God commanded him. If we rasamiha vachan vatsala, we realize how God has given him each and every work. Manje kasa bandhayacha, how things are supposed to be, how things are kept to be. Kiti centimeters, kiti cubits, kuta roof asala paije, kuta door asala paije. If you go to see, Noah was a very normal person. He wasn't a इंजिनियर या फिर क्या कुठला मोठा कंस्ट्रक्टर नव्हता. बट बिकॉज ऑफ हिम बिलीविंग इन गॉड, गॉड गेव हिम द विजडम ऑफ बिल्डिंग इट. इफ यू रीड दिस दिस वर्स एंड दिस चैप्टर, वी रियलाइज दैट हाउ गॉड वॉक्ड विथ हिम एंड वी कैन सी द एविडेंस ऑफ नोहा सैल्वेशन. देर आर फोर पॉइंट्स विच आर इम्पॉर्टेंट. द वर्क ऑफ होली स्पिरिट इन हिज लाइफ, ही बिगैन टू सी गॉड, ही रिस्पॉन्डेड टू गॉड्स ग्रेस. His faith in God was so great. It is so important for us to see how Noah was. Tani ekune goshta follow keli without doubting God, without thinking twice, he kay hote hi kay na. Let us read Hebrews chapter 11 verse 7. By faith Noah, when warned about things not yet seen, in holy fear built an ark to save his family. By his faith he condemned the world and became pure of righteousness that is in keeping with the faith. Apan jeva he words vachto, we understand how Noah was so faithful and so obedient to God. Like sagya goshti madhe he was obedient. Because of his faith he could build that up. And seeing him and seeing his faith, like something tyane kadhi baghitla nahota. He never saw, not someone came and told him, but God told him that things are going to go bad. And seeing that, he built that, he did whatever God wanted to. That's a faith bagun, it changed the kid's life, the children's life. And that's how his children, you know, grew in God's faith. If we read 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 5, it's written, if he did not spare the ancient world when he brought the flood on its ungodly people, but protected Noah, a preacher of righteousness, and seven others. We see that Peter calls Noah that he was a preacher of righteousness because he stayed faithful and obedient to God throughout his life, throughout his job. And obviously when we see our parents or when we see our fathers doing some work so obediently, we are so inspired and we see them and we say, no, I am going to be the same, I will do the same. That's the same which happened with his kids also. The next person I'll be talking about is Abraham. Abraham, I have named Abraham as a good father. Abraham always had challenges in his life, throughout his life actually. He had problems when he was a kid, when he got young, even when he got married to Sarah, he had issues, he had problems. After 100 years, when he turned 100, he conceived, and he and Sarah conceived Isaac. That's the patience level kiti asil. Imagine the hope, the faith which he had in God was so much. Like if we compare ourselves with him, अपन कितनी इम्पेशेंट होते हो. लाइक इफ समथिंग गोज रॉन्ग, इफ समथिंग इज लेट, वी अपन कितनी चिड़चिड़ करते हो. वी आर लाइक का असं होता है, वाई इज दिस हैपनिंग टू अस, वी गेट सो इम्पेशेंट. बट ही वॉज नेवर लाइक दिस बिकॉज हिज फेथ वॉज सो मच इन गॉड एंड ही बिलीव इन गॉड सो मच. देर आर थ्री मेजर रीजन्स वाई वी कॉल अब्राहम एज गुड फादर. फर्स्ट मेजर रीजन इज दैट ही लीड्स हिज फैमिली. अब्राहम kept charging forward in leading and directing his family. त्याचे जे पण ऑर्डर्स होते ते गॉडकडून आले बिकॉज ही वॉज सो क्लोज टू गॉड. बट इवन इफ द ऑर्डर्स वर फ्रॉम गॉड, द एक्झिक्युशन वॉज डन बाय हिम. हिज द वे टू वर्क, हिज डिरेक्टिव्स, द वे ही एक्झिक्युटेड, इट वॉज ओनली बिकॉज गॉड हेल्प्ड हिम. इवन इफ ही एक्सपीरियन्स्ड हार्डशिप्स अँड मिसस्टेप्स अलॉन्ग द वे. आर फादर्स आर ऑल्सो द सेम. If we compare our fathers with Abraham, our fathers have to take such major decisions in life. Why do we call our father as the head of the family? Because all the major decisions are taken by him. Like investing money into in mutual fund asso, gharamadhe asso, in gold asso, buying a new house or sending their daughter or their kids to abroad. It's like kiti major decisions hai which get so many changes in life. You all think ki आपल्या पेरेंट्स आपल्या फादर्सला टेन्शन येत नसेल ऑफ यु नो इन्व्हेस्टिंग सो मच ऑफ मनी, येत असेल. बट वाय डू दे हॅव दॅट मच ऑफ फेथ दॅट वॉट एव्हर इज हॅपनिंग फॉर गुड? बिकॉज दे हॅव फेथ इन गॉड, दे बिलीव इन गॉड. एस्पेशली वेन देर इज अ डिसिजन ऑफ आर फादर्स, यु नो, जेव्हा आर फादर्स पुश अस टू गो अहेड टू स्टडी अब्रॉड, they have to think twice while sending their daughters, because their daughters or their sons, because life is going to be different, it's going to be difficult. But our father have that faith in God that whatever he is doing for his kids will be right. The second reason is, he is a good father because he teaches his children about God. Abraham had to sacrifice Isaac. Imagine that your manamadhi kitti kai goshti chalat asel, like, why is this happening? Asa ka hote, tala kitti tras zala asel. Imagine his first kid and tala sacrifice karava lagla. But he never questioned God, he never doubted God. You know, aplya life madhe there's a moment when, you know, we lose a friend, or apan thode grades aplyala kami yetat, or we lose some job. Or something like that, you know. Apan kiti chid karto ya sa ya goshtinvar. But when we have to look at the bigger picture of what God is going to do in our lives. He was ready to sacrifice Isaac, but God didn't take him. In fact, God returned him in so many and so greater things. Let's read Isaiah 51, verse 1 and 2. Listen to me, you who pursue righteousness and who seek the Lord. Look to the rock from which you cut and to the quarry from which you were hewn. Look to Abraham, your father, and to Sarah, who gave you birth. When I called him, he was only one man, and I blessed him and made him many. It's like, if we read this verse, he was so obedient to God. He was so honest with God. He never such a faith kadi ikada tikada nahi zala. The same way how Noah was. So we need to understand how Abraham, our fathers, they do some things which are hard for them, but they still do it because they have faith in God. They believe in God, whatever they are doing is right. And because of Abraham as a good father, his children walked in the same way. The third reason is, a good father respects, honors, and believes in God. Abraham was not a big man or a performer or a scholar. He simply respected God. He was obedient to God. And his obedience toward God changed his children's life, changed and, you know, inspired his children to believe in God more. I'll be talking about Joseph. Joseph was not a biological father to Jesus, but he became everything. He made sure that he was a father to him, to help him, to grow him in God's faith. God knew that Jesus needed an earthly father too. Mary was there, and we all know that mothers are someone to someone who will love you, who will care about you. But Jesus equally needed a father too. If we read Ephesians chapter 6, verse 4, it's written, fathers, do not exasperate your children. Instead, bring them up in the training and instruction of the Lord. If we see, Joseph is a person that God keeps reminding us that fatherhood is not easy. Fatherhood is not a hobby, but it's a vocation. Vocation means a something which is given to you, a work which you're supposed to complete, and it's like a calling for you that you have to complete. It is definitely something which is sacred and which is very holy. And Mary and Joseph both played an amazing role in Jesus' life. If we read Luke chapter 2, verse 33, we see, the child's father and mother marveled at what was said about him. So they both played an amazing role in Jesus' life. Joseph was a good father because he protected his family, led them, worked for them, cared for them, and taught them. He was but a mask for Father in heaven, who used Joseph as his hands and feet and mouth to care for the Savior and his mother. When we read Matthew verse 1, chapter 1 verses 18 to 25, it's written, Joseph accepts Jesus as his son. This is how the birth of Jesus was, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him, and took Mary home as his wife. But he did not consummate that marriage until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus. If we see here, Joseph was scared. He was obviously scared because he had to do something which he never planned of. But when the angel came to him, spoke to him, when God spoke to him, he understood that he is given some responsibility which is important. And he had that much of faith in God, and whatever God is doing for him is something which is going to get, which is going to be a good fruit. He did play a very major role in Jesus' life. If we see that God would have taken the responsibility of growing Jesus in faith, but God wanted Jesus to have a father, an earthly father, and Joseph played an amazing role of growing Jesus in God's faith, to grow him as a good person. If we see our conditions, our father will never, the way Joseph is, our father will never abandon us in difficult situations. Even however difficult the situation, however how bad we behave, he will never abandon us. If especially in this situation, in this lockdown situation, there are so many people who don't get food, especially some parents who can't give food to their kids. Do you really think those fathers will leave their children at home? No, because they are fathers. The love of the father is great and is amazing, and that's the same thing which we can see in Joseph's life. And the last part about the sermon is that I'm going to talk about the love of the Father in heaven. अपन गॉड ला कसं इमॅजिन करतो. वी ऑल हॅव डिफरंट व्ह्यूज अबाउट हाउ गॉड इज, हाउ गॉड लुक्स एंड एव्हरीथिंग. मे बी वी इमॅजिन गॉड ॲज अ पर्सन हू सिटिंग ऑन अ थ्रोन, त्याचा आवाज मॉर्गन फ्रीमन सारखा आहे, अ समन हू मेक्स अ डेड अ लाईफ, अ समन हू इज वेरिंग अ लाँग, कोणीतरी म्हणजे गॉडने असा मोठा जगा घातला आहे विथ अ ऑक कलर शॉल, असं आपण इमॅजिन करतो. अ समन हू वी शुड बी फिअरफुल ऑफ, अ समन हू इज व्हेरी स्ट्रिक्ट, someone who will get angry on us if we do something wrong. So we have all different views about God. But when Jesus was born, when Jesus came alive, when Jesus was there to talk to people about God, he changed the perspective about people, about God in to everyone. When we see, when we read Luke chapter 11, je aapla Bible reading ahe, when we read that, त्याच्यामध्ये आपल्याला कळतं, वेन डिसायबल्स केम टू आस्क जीसस अबाउट हाऊ डू वी प्रे गॉड, हाऊ डू वी प्रे जीसस, तेव्हा जीसने एकच आन्सर दिलं. वेन ही स्टार्टेड ही सेड ही इज रिटन दॅट आ फादर इन हॅवन, ही हॅज क्लिअरली मेन्शन दॅट वी नीड टू प्रे टू गॉड बाय कॉलिंग हिम आ फादर. ही कुड हॅव इझिली, त्यांनी इझिली सांगितलं असतं दॅट यू रिलेट टू गॉड, कॉल गॉड, पण त्यांनी ते नाही सांगितलं. ही केप सेइंग दॅट यू नीड टू pray and you need to say that our father in heaven. We realize and we understand and when we see this, that you know, the father in heaven, our God, is so proud of us. He loves us, he wants to protect us, someone who cheers us and lifts up when we fall. By this we understand God is not strict or angry or mad at us, but he is in madly love with us. Jesus kept saying your father. He kept telling all the disciples, all the people, that you know, when you pray, say that our Father in heaven. He kept reminding us that God is not only a creator of this world, but he is our heavenly Father. You know, we need to understand this concept that God loves us the way our Father loves sitting with us, listening to our stories, listening to our details of the day. This is the same way, and God is the same way. God wants to listen to us, he wants us to be in his presence, talk to him, pray to him, ask him all the questions, all the doubts you have, and he is happily ready to sit with you, answer those questions. He gets excited when you are around him. You know, it's very important that God loves your presence. God loves when you sit and when you talk to him. Imagine if God has made birds, trees, in such an amazing way, and he cares about them so much. Imagine how much he loves you and how much he cares about you. You know, there are times when we feel down, when we feel that we are not good enough or we don't get good grades from some person. We start comparing our lives. But we need to understand that in God's way, we are very unique and he has made us in an amazing way. God calls us, he has carefully designed us, and he calls us as his masterpiece. So it's very important. He calls us his masterpiece, and that's such an important thing to consider. You know, जेव्हा आपण लहान होतो और वेन वी परफॉर्म फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम ऑन द स्टेज, लाईक वेन वी डान्स्ड फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम अँड वी सँग अ सॉन्ग फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, वेन वी प्रीच्ड फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, आर पेरेंट्स लाईक आर मदर फादर वॉज सिटिंग ऑन द फर्स्ट बेंच रेकॉर्डिंग अस. I mean, they have already listened to it. There is no actually necessary to record it and keep it for future, but they will still do it. Why would they do it? Because they are proud of us and they love us for the things you do. You know, when we read Psalms chapter 1 verse 3, it's written, that person is like a tree planted by streams of water, which yields its fruit in season and whose leaves does not wither, whatever they do prosper. In the same way, God is, you know, holding a camera in our lives, and he loves recording us. When we are walking in his path, when we are, you know, read his Bible, when we pray to him, when we are within his presence, he loves the way we are. He loves recording us. There are so many angels which can record us, and which can, you know, record and keep the clips of what we do in our life, which is good. But he himself, he swata to camera tacha hatat ghetla by recording us, because he keeps cheering us. He wants us to grow more in him and be a good person. You know, how do you picture God as a father who's recording you? He is someone who is just recording you and just recording the things which you do. He does not replay your mistakes, or, you know, he will be like, no, he needs okay liye, so he asa nahi karala paise tasa nahi. He never does that. He loves the way you are. Because of his love on us, we can overcome all the challenges in our life. It's important that if God stands by us, nothing can be against us. The way, you know, if there's a story, you know, it's like, imagine a father is teaching his son to climb a tree, but he tells his kid ki tu jhaad chadu nako jao mi tujhe aaraun nasi. Why does he say that? Because he doesn't want him to get hurt. So one fine day asa hota ki that child climbs on the tree when his father is not around, and he starts screaming loudly ki papa mala vachav mi adakla ahe, like I don't know what to do now. Will his father go help him? का त्याचे रिपोर्ट कार्ड उघडेल आणि बघेल ना ह्याने एवढ्या चुका केल्या आहेत, त्याने एवढ्या मला एवढं खोटं बोललं आहे, फिर ही हॅज हर्ट मी दॅट मच. ही विल नॉट थिंक दॅट वे. ही विल सिम्पली गो अँड हेल्प हिज किड, अँड ही विल रिमूव्ह हिज किड फ्रॉम दॅट सिच्युएशन. इट्स इन द सेम वे. गॉड विल नेवर रिप्ले युअर मिस्टेक्स ऑर कीप सेइंग दॅट यू हॅव डन दिस मिस्टेक, दॅट्स वाय आय विल नॉट हेल्प यू. ही विल हेल्प यू इन ईच अँड एव्हरी वे. यू नो, इट्स सेड दॅट गॉड नोज द काउंट ऑफ हेअर ऑन युअर हेड. It's such a great thing. Imagine, he knows the number of hair you have on your head. So he does bother the small, small things in your life. He wants to know the things which are going in your life. We might think, what, God might doesn't care how much we score, or how, if I get sleep or not, if I'm happy or not. He does care. He wants you to have a good sleep. He wants you to be happy in your life. He wants you to get good grades. He wants you to be a good person. God wants you to go talk to him before, when we sleep, before eat, before we take any decision in our life. It can be a small decision, big decision, it can be anything. He wants us to talk to him. You know, we think, how are we supposed to talk to God? Are we supposed to be formal? No, there's no need to be formal. God is our father. Jesus has said that he is our father. The way we talk to our father, our earthly father, that you know, asa zhala, tasa zhala, we want this, we want that. That's the same way we need to talk to God, because he loves us and he loves all his kids. And he is willing to give you the wisdom, the knowledge, and each and everything which you need in your life. When we go into his presence, he will give you all the amazing things which he has stored in his kingdom for you. His mercy, his wisdom, his knowledge, his love, his grace, each and everything. You know, if we read Luke 15 and we listen to the story of prodigal son, the story is so beautiful. We learn so many things from that. When the son leaves his father, he goes away, he, you know, spends all his money. Then he realizes what he has done. He realizes, he prepares a speech to go and tell his father, like, he's sorry and everything. But what does his father do? The moment his father sees him, he forgets each and everything. He forgets what he would have done, what he has done, how many money he has spent. But what he does, he hugs him tightly and he celebrates. But still, the son is ready to explain him what wrong he has done. But he doesn't listen. He's happy that his son has returned home and is ready to stay with him. It's in the same way. Our father loves us. How much ever we go away from him, or how much ever wrong we do, if we ask for forgiveness, he will forgive you. He will love you. So on this Father's Day, let's be grateful for our Heavenly Father, for the fathers, our earthly fathers, our mothers, and each and every person. It can be our teacher, it can be a mentor, anyone. It's very important to be grateful, to be thankful, to have some such people in our life. I hope Maza Sandesh, it तुमच्यापर्यंत पोचला असेल अँड इट कुड बी अ गुड इम्पॅक्ट ऑन ईच अँड एव्हरी पर्सन. माझ्याकडून कुठली चूक झाली असेल सो आय एम रिअली सॉरी. आय थँक पास्टर अँड चर्च मेंबर्स फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्च्युनिटी. अँड आय अगेन विश ऑल द फादर्स अँड ऑल द सिंगल मदर्स हॅपी फादर्स डे. लेट्स एंड दिस सर्मन विथ अ प्रेयर. थँक यू लॉर्ड, थँक यू जीसस, थँक यू होली स्पिरिट, थँक यू फॉर letting me talk through you, Lord Jesus. Thank you for letting me talk through your spirit, Lord. We pratna karte, Lord. I give all the fathers in your hand. They have done such amazing things for us, Lord. And they deserve all the happiness in this world, Lord Jesus. We all kids, we all, Lord, ask for your forgiveness if we have hurt them in any way, Lord Jesus. And forgive us for that, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I give this prayer in your name. Amen.
आता आपल्यासमोर क्यूट लिटल ग्रेस फादर्स डे साठी स्पेशल ॲक्शन सॉन्ग परफॉर्म करणार आहे.
वृष्टि कृपेची ईश प्रेमोक्ति असे तेने दृष्टि पुष्टि यांची वृष्टि जगी होतसे वृष्टि
आता आपले सन्माननीय बाळासाहेब आपला आशीर्वाद देतील व त्यानंतर आजची भक्ती इथे संपेल.
आपण आशीर्वाद घेऊया. आमच्या यहोवा परमेश्वराची कृपा, प्रभू येशू ख्रिस्ताची शांती आणि पवित्र आत्म्याचं सहभागीपण देवाच्या प्रियजनांबरोबर आता आणि युगाच्या समाप्तीपर्यंत राहो. आमीन.